Hi, I'm Vince.
Hi, I'm George.
Congratulations on making it through this course. Now you'll have an opportunity to look in on an interview while it's happening. This interview will include technical topics from the course.
We hope that this helps as you prepare for your next interview.
So what interests you in a career in cloud data analytics?
What got me interested about a career in cloud data analytics was in college, everyone was talking about the cloud and how powerful that it can be and how much it seemed like it was the future of where technology was heading. And it sounded like something I'd be interested in. I started to look more into the cloud and how I can use it in my studies in business. And I saw how scalable and how powerful it could be and decided that it was an area that I wanted my career to go into.
So can you tell me about a favorite data analytics project that you worked on and tell me what your role was and what you liked about the project?
My favorite data analytics project was one where I was a data analyst, where I got to combine all of these data sets about compressors and engines, where I was able to put them up in the cloud and perform some statistical analysis to help prescribe if they're gonna have some sort of maintenance event or fail. And I really liked it because it had a real world impact.
Suppose you're working for a company that wants to modernize their data lake and their data warehouse. What are some components of a modern cloud data platform they should consider?
They should consider their ETL policy, their data lifecycle policy, their privacy policies, and then how they're gonna scale all their data and make it available, and if they can apply any machine learning or AI onto it.
So when it comes to ETL, can you talk to me about the differences between batch processing and stream processing?
The differences between batch processing and stream processing is, for batch processing, you will process all of your data at once in one large workload. But for stream processing, you're going to process each little bit of data that comes through your system.
Can you tell me some use cases for each?
A good use case for batch processing would be data analytics. If you want to perform data analytics around how a product might be performing, you want to have a complete picture of the performance. And so for batch processing, you would wait until you have a complete data set. A good use case for streaming data would be like stock trading. You want to know where the market is moving at any given minute, and you can't wait until the end of the day. And so you would need to process that data in real time.
Can you give me an example of a problem that a streaming data source would solve?
A problem that a streaming data source would solve might be something like an intrusion detection, where a security company could monitor real-time data in order to determine if there's any unauthorized personnel in some perimeter. It could also be a virtual perimeter, like in the cloud.
All right, so imagine that you've been asked to build a new report for a toy manufacturing company. The report should contain the names of each toy built and the number of units shipped by each month. What data would you look for? And where would you look for this data in cloud tools?
If I wanted to create a report that showed each toy and how much we shipped each month, the first pieces of data that I'd be looking for is their manufacture date and the names of each of these toys and any variations of these toys, because we'd probably want to track that as well. And I would find all this information in BigQuery.
So what language would you use to query the data in BigQuery?
I would use structured query language, and that's how we talk to databases to retrieve any information that we need from them.
If you're looking to essentially query the number of units shipped by month, you don't have to sort of say the query exactly as you might type it into a console, but what might that query look like?
In general, that query would look like selecting all of the products and any variations of them that we might be interested in reporting on. And I would sum like a unique count of each product who had a manufacture date within a certain month. And I would aggregate those to get a view that shows for each toy that we produce, how many we ship that month.
Really appreciate you taking the time to interview with us. And I really wish you luck with the rest of the process.
Thanks, Vince. I really appreciate your time today, and it's been a pleasure.
Great to meet you. In this scenario, George demonstrated how to provide examples when answering questions. During an interview, you can differentiate yourself by providing examples of how you've used your skills in relevant situations. Watch for more interview tips later on in this program.